Good morning, YouTube. Okay, I'm inside the greenhouse, and a year later, I've decided it's time to put in a staircase from the porch down into the main part of the greenhouse, instead of having to step off the porch onto a step ladder and down. So, I've been thinking about how to teach someone to build stairs. Back when I was in high school, I worked for a master carpenter, and he taught me how to do it using nothing but measurements. I could build a staircase using a tape measure and no other tools. It took me the full of a year to learn that method. He had to reteach me every time we went to do it. So I'm trying to figure out a way to teach someone easily how to build a staircase. And what we're going to do, moving a little closer here. We're going to make a cardboard template. So the first thing we need to do is figure out what shape the stairs need to be. So basically, because there's... That's it. Keep talking with the pen cap in your mouth. Because there's an overhang, we have to get this measurement, this measurement, this measurement, and how wide we want the stairs to come out. So, ideally, we don't want the stairs to come out more than 36 inches, preferably more like 32. So this one's 32 to 36. Our height under the lip is going to be different on each side here. It is 25 3/4. Left side, on the right side, is about 25 5/8. Our overhang 4 inches on both sides. And the thickness of the top pad is 3 5/8. Is 3 1/2. And we're gonna make it 3 1/2. And then we also need to know how wide our stairs have to be. So we want a total of 36 inches. So 36 inch tread comes out 32 to 36 inches. The height is 30, 25 and 5/8 and 25 and 3/4. The overhang is 4 and the height of the pad is 3.5. So let's go over to the table out front of the workshop and figure out how to cut this. Okay, we're in the middle of a ladybug invasion. These Asian ladybugs, there's a million of them here trying to find a safe place to overwinter. So that's my okay ladybug, you pissed me off jar. As I am trying to figure out how to set up a habitat in which to overwinter ladybugs so that I have them for my greenhouse when the aphids start trying to take over my plants. So the first thing we need to do is measure out twenty-five and three-quarters. And come across square. Now, one thing you are going to need is a framing square. If you pick one up at a garage sale or a flea market, you're going to need to test to make sure it is square. And I have a video on how to do that. And we want to come out ...4 inches. Up 3.5. So now in the province of Ontario, the legal maximum height for a stair is 8 inches, although you're allowed to be a little bit over or a little bit under on your top and bottom stair, but every stair in between has to be exactly 8 inches. Because human beings are creatures of habit, and I'm going to spend more time putting ladybugs in the jar than I am working on the pattern. From here, we want to come down 8 inches. That's the top of our next stair. And just for arbitrary measurement's sake, we're going to say we're going to go at 10 inches for the step, the tread. square to that line, cross 10 inches, square to that line, and down is 10 inches. So that would not be a legal staircase in Ontario. So our difference is 2 inches. So we can suck up an inch at the top and an inch at the bottom. We're going to come down 9 inches. Measure across 1 inch. And from there, we're going to come down another 1 inch. Here, come down 1 inch. And we now have 9 inches, 8 inches, 9 inches. Now, this is the top height of the stair. So if you were doing a cutout stringer, you would want to come down again by the thickness of your tread board, which in most cases would be an inch and a half for a 2x10. And you just measure that down again the same way I did to make our stairs at 9 and 9 instead of 8 and 10. But I'm doing a live edge staircase, so I'm going to keep these as the top of my tread, and I need to get a straight edge. Now I know how long I need to cut that board would be just slightly longer than 48 inches. If I was doing it with a two by 10, that would be the board I have to cut. So I hope that clears up the method for how to lay out a set of staircases or a set of staircase stringers. That's it for now, and thanks for watching. Well, good afternoon, YouTube. In the middle of shooting the fourth video in this series, and I realized that on the first video I made a major screw up. So when I get to the point where I'm saying I'm used to major screw ups, that was before I found this one. So when we laid out the pattern in the first video, which this is going to be edited into, when we laid out the pattern, by accident, I measured my spacing off from the bottom of the lip of the concrete slab of our porch instead of the top. Now, I cut three treads because I knew that I'm going to need three treads to make this staircase. But because I measured off of here, I only marked it off for two. So, of course, this changes everything. I'm going to have to cut two new side pieces. I'm not going to bother filming that because cutting one side piece and another, the layout and the cutting is all exactly the same. So, what we're doing is we're going with a 7.5-inch height for the stairs. Pretty bad when you know how to do something and you do it wrong because you're trying to figure out a way to explain it to someone else. There's the new pattern for the stairs. As I said, I don't want it to be more than 36 inches. So I had stabbed a piece onto the end of the pattern here just to see how long it was going to be. And I'm going to stick to my original statement that I don't want it to be any longer than 36 inches. So now when we get to the video where I'm actually cutting things out, you'll see I'm cutting out this riser, or this stretcher, side, this one and that one. And in the assembly video, you will see me starting to assemble using this one, and then magically I will change over to using the one I cut out of this. I'm not going to film cutting this because it's exactly the same process as cutting these two. The stairs, all three, were filmed already. So anyway, this little clip will be added into the first video to explain my mistake when it happened. And hopefully we'll see you on the next video.